Hello everyone, welcome to Arthral Studio, and today we are going to see how we paint birds in Pichhwai. When we look at Pichhwai paintings, we see that there is a lot of emphasis on flora and fauna. So we see that even in the forest or the scenes, we see a lot of birds. We will be doing a peacock, peahen, and few of the water birds here. This is a bird that is in the waters, and for this I'm taking the poster colors. It's white, little bit black and blue, marina blue, and I'm creating a little details directly with the brush. You can visit all the elements that are already done. You can check on the tutorials that are posted on the channel of how to do flowers, how to do leaves, how to do the pond. And now we are doing the birds. Whenever I take the coloring, I take generally the three tones of the color: medium, dark, and the lighter tones. The importance of birds in the painting give a lot of value. They give the surroundings, they give life to the picture. And so if you add some elements like this, it doesn't look very quiet. It gives you a serenity, it gives you a little bit of life in your picture and creates the mood. So here in this picture, this is a very big picture, and that is why it's broken into different sections. We are doing few elements in one. In this video, we will be dealing with only the birds and the fish. There are small details to be taken care of while you are doing it. Generally, when we see these birds, we see that they are light in color. The seabirds, generally, mostly we see it's white, but still it's not pure white. We see the inlay of little bit of blues, pinks and purples. The same thing we will be doing it here. So the neck is long, and we will get a beautiful shade of the lightest and the darkest color in that. Pichhwai has a lot of details. They are big paintings and we can create a lot of details. Here I am taking the red, the poster red and white, to give it a little bit of wash on the head. So the head is a little red in color. A light wash of the colors. You can also use watercolors for the same. Here I am using poster colors, thinning it down a little. Between my washes, I wait for some time for it to absorb the paper, absorb the water, and then again I can start with that layering of my colors. Here I have added poster red plus a little bit of black to give that maroonish or dark color look. So we'll make a very bright head and the body will be light. You will see that the feathers will have a little shadow casted on the body, and you will see it in a different tone. Here we'll be completing the head. You would never achieve the same effects with a pen, color pens or brush pens. So try to get a little practice on your brushes if you are very keen to do it in this manner. A little black to give the deep eyes. So the lines have to be very fine. We don't want to make the blobs of big colors. So these black lines are also with a good force, and they are not everywhere. They are broken lines. Some places they are deeper, thicker. Some places they are thinner. And with this black outline, it gives a very prominent look to the bird. What birds we see are the swans, the ducks, the peacocks, the peahens, some which are very close to the water. And for the greenery, we see parrots, then parrots mainly on the birds. We see also in Pichhwai, we see a lot of trees with bigger fruits and flowers. We do see that, but in a little bit of refined manner. The pictures are not very big as we do it in other folk arts like Madhubani and all. So this is a little bit more details, the small thin down strokes are seen here. So here in this Athral studio, you will see that we have a lot of things. Definitely one painting cannot be covered in one tutorial, so it's broken down into small sections. But the day 1 and the day 2, day 3 and 4 are all covering the painting, which is a very big picture of A3 in A3 size and is filled with a lot of details. I'm trying to convey all the descriptions, how to do the shades and the coloring. So that's why this is taking a little bit of more time. And so this is a little bit of pinkish color that is seen under the feather. Now here we are going on to the fish. The fish is a very small element. We wouldn't see a very big fish like we see in other few of the art forms. The fish is really small. Here the perspective plays a very important role. The things are smaller and not in focus. So these fishes are not in focus, but still we see there is a twist in the body, and so there will be a lot of color play in this. I am taking the red color, yellow color and a little bit of white to give it a peachy color. Peachy color is like the color of peach, very skin color. I'm doing the half of the body on the top with the base color that I created, which is the middle tone. Middle tone is the medium shade. And now I'm giving the highlights with the lighter color and the depth with the darker colors. We will see when we look at the fish, we see that the body, the belly or the back under portion of the fish is always lighter. So creating that with white. Now taking a little bit darker color, doing the highlights or the giving a fine line to the top. We will be doing small details, even the smallest scales, eyes and fins in the smallest element. So you will get to see all the details. But here what plays very good is the practice when you can practice your thin strokes. Take a fine liner pen. Brush. Take a fine line brush and control your strokes. That will give you a good practice on the shade work as well. Now in the end we will be doing a little bit with the black to give it a little focus. So with the shades we see that the fish is all done, but later a little bit of black as an outline will add, bring our focus to the fish. So here is the eye. So I'm zooming this little fellow to give you a good view of it. You will see that the strokes get thin and thick at certain places. So you have to really control the pressure of your brush. Fins are very fine and transparent. So not necessary that you will outline the whole thing in the same fashion. A little bit of red with black gives a little darker tone. And just here and there, little shades. Here in this picture, we have created a lot of motion in the fish. So you will not see a straight one. They are all twisting and turning because they are in the movement. And we are trying to do the same. I would repeat the same, but here you can see with the movements how to play with the sheet work. Again, the body has the lighter tone at the bottom. Just doing the very same as I did for the first one, I'm doing it for all the fish that are there in the pond. In our series of Pichhwai paintings, this is one big painting that is broken into different days and different sections. So whichever you want to take up first, you can see and you can do the painting. We have another videos where we did the bird, which is a very elaborate version of the peacock. Peacocks are vastly seen in this picture in Pichhwai. We often see that the deity of Shrinath is surrounded by 12 peacocks or the cows. So these are the things that were there in the garden, and most of the time of Krishna as a young, in his teens probably I would say, was spent in the gardens with playing around, and early years were the times when he was a shepherd. So you will see a lot of cows. We will soon do a cow. There is a Shrinathji painting which is known for to be a very prominent painting in Pichhwai style. If you have not subscribed the channel, I request you please subscribe and press the bell icon for the notifications so that you get notified. If you have not visited my Instagram, do visit, and the links are all in the description box. This is how my pond looks. I hope you liked it. Thanks for watching.